What's up, Star Wars fans and action figure collectors? Darth Collector here, and in today's video, I'm going to be reviewing the 8D8 Power of the Force 2 action figure. Now, this is a figure I have two of. I have a loose one right here, as you can see. So, I'm going to be reviewing this guy. Let's get into it. Alright, so we're going to start off by taking a look at the card here. And obviously, this isn't the nicest card on mine. It has a price sticker here, you know, whatever. But let's start off on the back, and right here we can just see a picture of the figure along with a quick description, which looks like it's a cutout line if you want to do that. We've also got a couple other figures that are in the line, like the Morning Guard. I have like three of him. Got an 8D8 assemble as shown instructions here. It's just a picture of it, but you can see it like literally anywhere else, like in here. And then we got this special offer, just some random Kenner stuff, official fan club. I don't even know if that's a thing anymore. And we got the proof of purchase. So on the front we can see the freeze frame right here, and then just some of the other random stuff that's on the cards, like the picture and stuff. Anyway, so that's what the card is looking like, and if you want to, you can pause to read this. I didn't really give you a good chance there. And then here is the figure. So we're going to start off with the accessory this thing comes with. So you're going to find this, and it's going to come open like this, so it's not going to be assembled. All assembly is plug this in right here. There's really not much to it. So once you've done that, this thing essentially just stands up and it articulates right here, so you can kind of torture your gonk droid like you did in the movie. And it swivels right here. It does swivel right there. Yeah. Now, one of the things I found with this, you can't really position a droid very well in here. Like, I've tried hanging it from its feet and it just pulls the whole thing over. I've tried sitting it upside down, which works the best. But for a display, you might want to kind of jury-rig a little contraption, and that's kind of going to be what you're going to have to do. Now, taking a look at the figure itself, this 8D8 figure has some light piping eyes and is a 5 POA figure, maybe 6. With articulation at the head, swivels at the arms, swivels at the legs, it's a 5 POA figure. Now, if you want to see what the eyes look like when you shine the light directly behind them, here it is. You can see they glow a lot better. If I put it right up, you can't even see him very well. But there it is. It looks kind of like it's supposed to in the movie. But in just an average lit room like I'm in right now, you really can't tell at all that his eyes. Like, it's the same if I covered up or not. As for detail, this figure doesn't have an insane amount of detail. You know, it's sculpted fine. And it looks like the figure from the movie. It looks like the character itself. But obviously, it's a Power of the Force 2 figure, so you're not really going in expecting too much. You're kind of mainly using this guy as a background figure in like a display. Now, mine's feet are really warped. I don't know if that's from just having him sitting in a bin, like with other figures on top of him, or if that came like that. And looking on this one, I can't really tell, but he does look warped as well, looking in there. So I think they come warped, at least mine did, because they're pretty old. So I would be aware of that. Standing up, that does cause him some trouble, and he'll pretty much only stand up when you lean him against this thing, which, you know, that in itself is a bit challenging. You gotta position it right, but it will work. Now, on the bottom of the feet, if we get it to focus quickly, you can see the date it was released was 1998. It says LFL, copyright Kenner, and it says China. LFL stands for Lucasfilm Limited, by the way, if you weren't aware. Just something I figured out earlier today when recording another video with LFL. And yeah, so overall, out of 10, I'd probably give this guy a 5 out of 10. The feet being warped is really irritating when I'm trying to put them up on this thing and it just falls over a bunch. Obviously, though, Power of the Force figures, you're going in not really expecting too much. And, like, carded, I paid $4 for this guy, as you can see on the price tag. $3.99, $4. And I would recommend not paying more than that. I think that's a pretty fair price for this guy. $3 or $4 is pretty much what you're getting. And the freeze frames things are pretty cool, too. I'll try to shine a light back behind that so you can actually kind of see it there. Can't really, I don't have a reader for these, so I'll just shine the light. But yeah, there you go. And yeah, so overall, I mean, it's a Power of the Force figure. You know, you're kind of getting what you're getting. And I would recommend this if you're a Jabba the Hutt collector. You can kind of put it down in the background, just like I've been doing in my displays. Or just have a separate droid room, which I have with EV99 as well. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this review. Like I said earlier, I'd really appreciate it if you'd be willing to subscribe and hit the bell, because then you'll see the videos when they're brand new and you can comment or whatever. And then I'll be sure to reply to any comments that you guys leave. So thank you so much for doing that. Have a great day or night, wherever you may be. And may the Force be with you always.